What's going on, Fit Fam? My name is Megan Janice, and I teach women how to get a year-round goddess body bursting with energy by eating more and working out less, which means working out smarter instead of harder. If you really, really want that sexy year-round goddess body, you know what I'm talking about, small waist, poppin' booty, sculpted abs, arms, and legs, you're not gonna get it from cardio. You are gonna get it by getting super freaking strong. And the reason why is because when you get strong, your body builds muscle. And muscle is what you want when you say get toned. So how do we build muscle? Well, the other huge mistake that women are making in their workouts is focusing on the wrong exercises, meaning they spend all of their time using lighter weights, doing high reps, which is not the way to build muscle, and they do mainly isolation exercises. An isolation exercise is where you focus on one muscle group at a time. This is not the path to getting super strong and building tons of muscle effectively. The way that you're going to do that is by focusing on the opposite of an isolation movement, which is called a compound movement. A compound movement is where you utilize multiple different muscle groups simultaneously. The big six compound moves are the squat, deadlift, hip thrust, bench press, military press, and chin up. Even if you only did these six compound moves, you would get an insane body and you would build it quickly and keep it forever. And that's because these six moves are just that effective at building your whole body. Now, in this video, I'm gonna break down these six exercises, how to do the form correctly, and how you can get started with them even if you're a complete beginner, and how to then progress to being more advanced so that you can keep getting better and better results as you're getting stronger and stronger. So, how often do you actually need to be doing these exercises to get the results you want? Well, you should be hitting the weights at least 3 days per week. It's better if you can do 4 or even 5 if you're really keen, but minimum 3 is still going to be enough to get results. Now, in each of these workouts, you would want to focus on at least 2 of these exercises, if not more. The other thing you need to do is make sure that you're always getting stronger and stronger than you were previously. This means you need to train using progressive overload. This means that you are consistently progressing in the amount that you are overloading your muscles with resistance. So for example, you don't want to go in the gym and always lift the exact same weight again and again. This is because the way that we build muscle is we literally have to force our body to build it. And we force our body to create that muscle by getting stronger. So if you keep lifting a weight that your body is already used to lifting, you're not getting any stronger. So you have to continue to increase the weight that you are using. So you want to work in the rep range of 8 to 12 reps. So this means you need to find a weight that isn't so heavy that you couldn't even do 8 reps, but you can't pick a weight that's so light that you could easily do 12 or more. You want to find a weight that's just right, where you can do somewhere between 8 to 12 reps for 3 sets with good quality form, and it really should feel like those last 2 to 3 reps are super hard. All right, ladies, it's not supposed to feel easy. It's not supposed to feel like you can just bang out 30 reps. It's supposed to feel like your muscles are about to give out. That's how you know you are doing it correctly. So every single time you work out, you want to be increasing the weight that you use within your given rep range. And I promise you, as long as you do that, you are going to get super freaking strong. And with that, you're going to get an insane year-round goddess body that you can keep for the rest of your life. Let's get it. So the first exercise we're going to look at is my favorite, and it is the queen of getting insane glutes, and that is the hip thrust. So this is a full banded barbell hip thrust, what you're going to be doing once you are strong enough, but I'm going to show you how you can get started even as a complete beginner. So the beginner variation is going to be where you use a resistance band and try to use a fabric one. I actually lost mine. I have a new one on the way, so my friend lent me this rubber one, but I really prefer the fabric one. And then you're going to pick as heavy of a dumbbell as you can, and you're going to put it right on your hips. So I find I got to roll the dumbbell forward a little bit, kind of onto my thighs to be able to hinge all the way down. Then you're going to put your legs at 90 degrees with your toes pointed out slightly and your upper back on the bench, keeping your eyes looking straight ahead. Then you're simply going to drive through your heels, hinging at your hips and thrusting your glutes up into the air and giving it a nice little squeeze and hold at the top. So if you're a complete beginner, it's fine to start with the dumbbell, but I definitely recommend using one of these pre-loaded barbells, which your gym should have. And you want to use one of these just because you're going to have a lot more weight to work with. And when it comes to the hip thrust, you want to use as much weight as you can, because remember, your glutes are the biggest muscle in your entire body. So it can really handle a lot of weight, and you definitely got to put some mass on that ass if you want it to grow. So you're going to grab the preloaded barbell and make sure that you get some sort of cushion for the bar. Otherwise, it's going to dig into your crotch and it's going to be really uncomfortable on your hip bones. So I actually have my own barbell pad. I really recommend getting your own as well, just because you're going to be hip thrusting so much. But you can also use the ones that your gym has, or if you don't have one, you can get a yoga mat and fold it up a bunch of times and use that as a cushion. And then the exact same position as the dumbbell hip thrust, except this time you're able to use more weight because you have the preloaded barbell. Now, ideally, once you're really getting a bit stronger and feeling more confident, you want to get started doing a proper full barbell hip thrust. However, if you're not hip thrusting a ton of weight, if you're not using the 45 pounds on each side, the barbell is going to be too low to the ground because the other plates are too small. So to accommodate for that, what you can do is you can take one or two plates and put them on either side of the barbell so that the barbell will be elevated off of the ground so that you're going to have the height that you need to be able to do a full barbell hip thrust. So this requires a little bit of setup, which I know is kind of annoying, but trust me, it's going to be worth it because it's going to give you such good results. So you're going to put the plates on either side, and then you're going to put the barbell down and put each weighted plate, whatever weight you're going to use, on either side of the barbell. And then you're going to get into the same position, upper back against the bench, legs at a 90 degree angle underneath the bar with your band on, and then you're going to drive through those heels, thrust your hips up into the air, keeping your eyes looking straight ahead at the wall, hinging from your hips all the way up and all the way down and squeezing those glutes. Now, the last option you have is you can use the Smith machine, which is this machine that your gym should have, which is where the barbell is actually attached to the machine. You can't separate it. And you can do a hip thrust off of this, especially if, you know, you're kind of nervous to do the setup and you're still kind of trying to get used to the form. This is going to be completely safe because it's attached to the machine. And it's a good way to just get more confident with the range of motion and start to build up your strength before you go do a full proper barbell hip thrust. So you're going to put the weight on either side, get your barbell pad or your yoga mat for your cushion for your crotch, and put the bench as close as it needs to be so that your upper back is going to be against the bench while you're hip thrusting. Now, the only thing I don't like about a Smith machine hip thrust is that you're probably not going to be able to thrust all the way from the bottom because the barbell is going to get caught before it's going to touch the bottom of the Smith machine. And this is because it is just part of the Smith machine. It can't completely touch the ground. So that is the limitation of doing Smith machine hip thrust. That's why it's not really my favorite, because you can't thrust all the way from the ground up, which means you have a limited range of motion, which means you're not going to be getting the full power of the hip thrust from this exercise. However, it's okay to use as you're getting started and as you're trying to get comfortable and confident with your strength in the form. But I definitely encourage you to move on to regular barbell hip thrusts as fast as you can and just use the Smith machine to get started. All right, the next exercise we're going to look at that is my other favorite is the deadlift. This is a sumo deadlift where you have a wide leg stance, which is an amazing exercise for both your glutes and your hamstrings, which are the back of your legs. So again, I'm going to show you how you can get started with this exercise, even if you're a complete beginner, using a challenging set of dumbbells, whatever whatever is the weight that you can use. So what you're going to do is you're going to have a shoulder width distance with your legs, toes pointed out slightly, and then you're going to hinge back at your hips. So you really want to think almost as though there's a rope around your hips and there's somebody pulling your hips and your butt back towards the wall. So you want to keep your shoulder blades pinched and you always want to have your back nice and flat. You don't ever want to round your back. And again, pulling those hips back towards the wall and kind of sinking your weight into your heels. And then you're just going to have a slight bend in your knees and you're going to keep the dumbbell just grazing your thigh, coming all the way down until you can't go any lower, and then driving back up, pushing through your heels and giving me a nice little glute tuck and squeeze at the top. Okay, so after you have been doing some lifting with the dumbbells and you're ready to start to push a bit more weight, you're going to run into the same problem with a barbell deadlift as you would with a barbell hip thrust, which is if you're not using the bigger plates because you're not strong enough yet, you're not going to have that much space off of the ground, in which case you can add one or two plates underneath the plates of your actual barbell so that you have the room that you need. So getting into the setup, you want to make sure that the barbell is directly over the middle of your foot. That's how you know you're in the right position. Toes pointed out slightly with a wide leg stance. Then you're going to bend at the hips and grab the barbell shoulder width distance apart. Now that you're in this position, you're going to bend your knees, keeping that back flat, keeping your shoulder blades pinched, and with your head down with a nice straight back, no rounding. Now you are ready to pull that barbell. So you're going to push through your heels, bring the barbell all the way up, pretty much just almost grazing your shins and thighs, and a nice tuck and squeeze at the top. Now again, another option to get used to the deadlift is to do it on the Smith machine, which is going to be easy setup and it's going to be safe. However, I also am not a huge fan of Smith machine deadlifts for the same reason that I'm not with the hip thrust, just because you don't have the full range of motion. The bar can't go all the way to the ground because the Smith machine will block it from touching the floor. So you're not going to be able to get a full range of motion. But again, when you're just getting started, just building your strength and trying to get used to the range of motion, this is going to be good enough. But I do encourage you to move on to a regular barbell deadlift as fast as you can. All right, next we are going to be doing what I find the hardest but insanely effective, and that is the squat. So to get started, you're going to pick a set of challenging dumbbells, and there's two different ways you can kind of position the dumbbells. I like the one where you hold it right above your shoulders. Then the very first thing you want to do is give your hips a tiny hinge back, your hips and glutes, stick it back just a tiny bit, then bend your knees, and then sink down as low as you can and push up off your heels and tuck and squeeze those glutes at the top. So if it's too challenging to do two heavy dumbbells above your shoulder, another way you can do this is a goblet squat, which is where you have one heavy dumbbell right in front of your chest and hinge back at your hips and glutes, then bend your knees and sink down into that squat as low as you can, keeping your back straight, your chest and head up, and push off your heels and tuck and squeeze those glutes at the top. So I honestly think that most women are going to be able to jump right into an empty barbell back squat. So maybe do a dumbbell squat for a little bit just to get the hang of it and to get a little bit confident. But honestly, an empty barbell squat is really not that hard. The barbell alone should weigh 45 pounds and you should be able to do it after a little bit of dumbbell training. So get underneath that barbell, pinch your shoulder blades, and you're going to do the same range of motion where you stick your butt and hips back first, then bend your knees, and then sink down as low as you can, push up off those heels, tuck and squeeze the glutes at the top. So after you've gotten confident doing an empty barbell back squat and you feel strong enough, that's when you can start to add weight onto either side of the barbell. So you're just going to choose whatever plates are right for you, slap them on each side, and go through the exact same range of motion. And you're going to see how strong you get so fast from doing this exercise and how insanely fast your body responds and you get that amazing year-round goddess body. And again, you can do a Smith machine squat if you feel like, you know, you want to have a little bit more practice before going onto the actual barbell. So as you can see, I kind of like to step forward a little bit so that I can sink down into that squat. You want to get it at least parallel to the ground with your butt, and then push up off those heels. So again, you can try using the Smith machine to kind of get comfortable with the movement, but as soon as you can, get onto that actual barbell because that's where you're going to get the best results. All right, next we're going to look at the bench press, which a lot of women think is only for men and that it's going to make them look manly if they do, but actually it gives your lady parts, your boobs, a nice little natural lift. So it's actually a natural alternative to getting a boob job, and it looks very nice and it makes you look feminine, not masculine. So you're going to lay down on a bench and have your feet firmly planted into the ground, your back flat against the bench, and then you're going to put your challenging set of dumbbells on either side of your body, keeping your arms as low to your sides as you can with a bent elbow. And then you're just going to bring those dumbbells directly up and above your chest. And you're going to know it's in the right position when it's directly over your nipple line. That's where you want to be lifting it over and then touching it down to your chest and repeating. So once you're strong enough, you're going to be able to do it with an actual barbell. So unlike a squat, doing upper body lifts with a barbell is a lot more challenging because as women, we naturally don't have as much strength, as much muscle in our upper body. So doing just an empty barbell bench press might feel really hard for some of you ladies, and that's okay. It was really hard for me in the beginning too, but you get super strong very fast. You're going to see there's little lines on the barbell where you can put your third finger around, and that's how you're going to know where your hand should be on the barbell. And then you're just going to be bringing the barbell directly up and over your chest, touching it to your boobs, to your nipple line, and pushing it up again. All right, next exercise we're going to look at is one of my favorites for upper body, and that is a military press, which is the queen of building those shoulders. So we're going to start it off with just dumbbells, and fortunately the range of motion is pretty easy on this. You just want to start with the dumbbells directly at your shoulders and push them all the way up overhead until your arms are fully extended, dumbbells almost touching. And then once you're strong enough, try it with the actual barbell. So not gonna lie, even an empty barbell for a military press is very challenging because our shoulders are a very small muscle group and the barbell is 45 pounds. So it's going to be pretty heavy, but I'm gonna tell you right now, it is an amazing shoulder pump. You feel so good, so strong when you're lifting that barbell directly up and over your head. Okay, on to the very last of these major compound moves, we have the chin up. So if you're a complete beginner, you can get started using one of these machines in your gym, which is an assisted pull-up / chin-up machine. You're going to have your palms facing each other, gripping the little handles right in front of you, and then you're simply coming all the way down from a dead hang. You want to make sure that you're literally completely slack with your arms fully extended to start, and then you're going to pull your weight up all of the way to where your chin is actually at the level with the handles and lower yourself back down to a complete dead hang. So once you have built up some strength on your chin up, what you can do is find a bar in your gym where you could wrap a long resistance band around. So this is kind of the next level, is still using resistance band, and then hopefully one day you'd be able to do them without any bands at all. I myself can only do a few chin ups without a band, so I often still use a band to be able to get more total reps in. Lower yourself all the way to a dead hang, completely not tensing your muscles, and then you are going to pull yourself up all of the way. All right, ladies, thank you so much for joining me. I hope that this video was helpful. Please make sure to give a like and subscribe so you don't miss any more good stuff coming out on my channel, and I'll see you in the next video.